Thank you. Tonight, we want to thank the people for inviting us. We're glad you're here with us. We're going to show you a little bit of Texas party business. Mr. Rusty Burns is going to show you how to do it.
Oh, just don't load my gun.
Yeah.
We understand this is the 13th anniversary of the Rockpalast. Is that correct? Well, it's about the 30-year anniversary for us. We've been semi-retired for a while, but thanks to the kindness of you people and all the other people here in Europe, we're going to be doing our first tour ever in Europe, and you're the second stop. Yeah! We're going to do a tune off the new album, The New Reloaded. It's a thing called Stars and Scars.
I'm searching.
member or two with us. But let me introduce you to him. First of all, on the drums, Mr. Danny Cochran from Fort Worth, Texas. From Austin, Texas, Mr. Larry Telford on the piano. And this fellow on my right you may have seen before, this is Mr. Buddy Whittington from the John Mayall and the Breakers.
Here's a little tune right here about the kinky ads. This is called the Romance Classified. Well, he'll business man. He likes his fun and games in the afternoon because his wife doesn't understand. Financial assistance, your phonograph gets fast. Gonna find a sugar daddy in the romance classified. Socials in the verbs. Some want to be observers. Some just want to be on the 1-900, and the timeline gets too hard. On the 7.95 per minute, build a screen to your credit card. Look out!
such a creepy man. I know that's the truth. They're supposed to keep us all happy, so we don't have to pay no more dues. But they always try to hassle us, baby. You know they got us all set in the rules. They can't even take a little ride to see the sights about the old town. Such a free, free, do it! It's a little new tune here that's going to be on the new album coming out after Christmas. It's a sad, sad story, I think, called Down on the Bottom. Down on the bottom, down looks up to me.
Tell us the story about the reunion of Point Blank.
Well, we had an original road crew member named Preston Green that needed a transplant operation. And in order to do that, he had to have a certain amount of money in the bank. And we got to talking and said, one way we can do this is maybe get back together and do a show and see if we can raise some money and help Preston and see what happens. And that's why it came together, and we got together and we had our first rehearsal. And we kind of looked around at each other and said, well, let's go through back in the alley. And we played all the way through it and went, that wasn't bad. Let's try something else. And that's where we are now. It just all kind of came together, and here we are.
Cool. And what can you tell us about your whole history?
Well, we became a band September 19th, 1974. We toured for 2 years without a record at all. Some pretty major touring with Kiss, ZZ Top, Aerosmith, REO Speedwagon. We worked with a lot of different acts over those 2 years without any product. We had written a bunch of songs. We managed to fortunately get into the studio and basically recorded the first two records minus two songs on the first sessions. So we had written those songs, like I say, in those 2 years previous to recording them. We recorded the things, got the first two records behind us, and then Arista Records kind of fell by the wayside, and we got a new deal with MCA Records and just continued forth. I had signed with Bill Hamm, which is ZZ Top's manager and was subsequently our manager, for a couple of years. I looked for players all over the United States. I worked for ZZ for a few years as a guitar technician, stage man, whatever they needed done. You know, we're only a three-man crew, and I couldn't find anybody I wanted to play with in the United States except the guys that I'd already been playing with in clubs over the years. So I just said, hey guys, I got a deal. You want to make a band? And they said, sure. So we put the thing together, and I think to really explain what we did, you get on the bus, you leave, and you don't come back. We toured relentlessly. I think in 1976, we were in the Guinness Book of World Records for the hardest touring band in the business, 300 and some odd shows that year. So everybody lost their old ladies. You know, the family forgot what we looked like. I came back, I had a beard, you know, I was clean shaven, no.
The total ZZ look-alike.
I had this first. I'll go ahead and tell you straight up. I grew the beard.
It's good to know for us.
Okay, Billy, you heard that, didn't you? I showed you how to grow a beard, my brother. No, I love Billy and Dusty and Frank. Great guys. If you would have told me 2 years ago that I would be sitting here talking to you in Germany, I would have said you're out of your mind. So I think there was a lot of things, a lot of business left undone with Point Blank, because there was kind of a nasty ending to the thing as far as litigations and just all that crap that's associated with business. We weren't really interested in business. We were interested in playing music. That was the fire in our belly. And here we are. We can't believe it yet. I mean, it's like we pinch each other every day, and it's like, are we dreaming or is this really happening? It's